Hey, everybody. Good afternoon. Good Sunday afternoon to you all. Thank y'all for being here. Listen, I went to church this morning with Pastor Lorenzo and Greta. And when I tell you wonderful service, wonderful, wonderful service. And on the drive home, you guys, I was listening to YouTube, some videos, and up popped a video of the great, the legendary RonKenoly in concert. You guys, he's almost 80 years of age. You wouldn't be able to tell by the way he looks, and his voice is just as wonderful as it was back in the day. Those of you who remember him, y'all come on back. We're about to have a conversation about the Dr. RonKenoly. He's out here doing concerts, y'all. Y'all want to come on now? Let's lift him up together. I'm going to be right back after this intro, and we're going to have a chat.
Welcome to the Juice Radio Talk Show. 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 Reality TV, church reviews. Let's talk happy love and marriage lifestyle. Come and talk with us. Come and share with us. With us. Come and laugh.
Regina, COVID, special guest. You should be following your lead. Bless, subscribe on YouTube, listen on podcast. We live on IG and Facebook. This episode is sponsored by Truth and Triumph Ministries.
All right, good Sunday afternoon to you all. Thank you all for being here. Listen, you guys, I've got a video that I'm going to share with you. Actually, some information. Let me get these other audios up. I got some information I want to share. Those of you who are from my era, we'll say, and probably before my era, you may all remember, if you're in the gospel world back then and you love great gospel worship music, then you will know this gentleman, Dr. RonKenoly. If you guys, I may be saying, you know, I say Kenoly, some people say Kenoly, whichever way, y'all know him, y'all know what I'm talking about. If you do, let me know in the chat, give me a thumbs up, let me know, even if you're watching this on the replay, thumbs up in this video to let me know if you remember RonKenoly, great music. Lift him up. Come on now. Y'all remember all the great music that he had? You guys, I was surprised today as I was scrolling through YouTube. He is doing concerts today. What? All right, you guys. So Dr. RonKenoly, he's almost 80, you guys. 80 years of age. Doing concerts, and he's doing his legendary great worship music that we all love from back in the day. I remember these, man, sitting in the church, listening to this concerts. I've been to some of the, when he came to some of the churches that I attended, and he would do his concerts. And I mean, it was just the music that Ron would give us in the gospel community would just make you feel as though you were at heaven's throne. This is the music that I grew up on. My mother would play it on the 8-track, on the VHS. She would play this music and we would just enjoy, enjoy, enjoy it. So I wanted to go live today on a beautiful Sunday. Why not on a beautiful Sunday? And tell you guys, those of you who like RonKenoly, Kenoly, however y'all say it, I'm gonna say Dr. Ron, y'all need to know this. I put all the links in all of my channels today. Normally, I only put it in my YouTube channel, but because, listen, it's Ron, all the channels today got the links, okay? All the channels, those of you on YouTube, on Instagram, I'm sorry, the link is not there, but y'all come on over here to my Instagram, to my YouTube page, and it's there. So RonKenoly, you guys, like I said, those of you who may not know who he is legendary in the gospel world. Legendary. Let me just give you a brief bio of him, and then I'm going to share with you this channel that's on YouTube where you can watch this video. And at 80 years of age, y'all, he gave me hope for the future because the way he was on stage moving up and down them steps. Listen, I didn't see past, 60 years of age? I did not see it. I would not have ever looked at Ron and thought him to be over 60. I mean, amazing looking, and his voice is still like it was back in the day. Now, y'all know I cannot run the music when it's on YouTube, and that's why I shared with you guys in the link. Y'all can see it in the description there, okay? In the link, y'all can listen to it. Y'all can have a beautiful time listening to it. He is there, okay? The video is there. Let me show y'all this. Look at him here. Look at Ron. Look at Ron. Ron. Lift him up. Y'all, this video had me bumping in the car today for through gospel music. I rolled the windows down. I opened up the sunroof. I was like, we'll let this prayer just go all outside of the car because we about to bless G Streets. We about to bless the streets. Y'all can tell how excited I was when this video popped up on my timeline saying RonKenoly live in concert. I had to turn to my husband. I said, RonKenoly still alive? And my husband's like, I don't know. And I said, hold on, let me check. Cause y'all know I will fact check something before I put it on my video, right? Love y'all for watching. Hey, all y'all just tuning in. I will fact check something. So I started checking. I said, I hope nobody not trying to play no jokes on us. No jokes, y'all. This concert was just in March of 2024. March of 2024, y'all. And when I tell y'all it was so good, Ron gave a full concert of his greatest hits and also some new music that I had not heard. Yes, it was so good. Now, he was at the church of this pastor who's in, let me show y'all, this pastor, and I'm going to give y'all his itinerary also. This is the pastor. Let me bring this on screen because thank God to this pastor. And also I found some information about this pastor. I think I might like this particular pastor here because I'm going to be sharing a video later. I'm going to be sharing a video later about something that happened at this pastor's church. And this pastor was like, oh no, we're not doing that here. And he stopped at mid process. The lady was trying to testify. She was actually testifying. She was testifying. Maybe I'll run it at the end of this video. But this pastor was like, no, you ain't gonna lie up in here. Well, I'm gonna share that with y'all at the end of this video. But going back to Ron, here's the pastor here. And his name, let me bring up this pastor's name. This pastor's name is Pastor Inichi. I may be saying that wrong. Pastor Inichi, I might be doctor, his pastor, Dr. Paul Inichi. That's his name, okay? And he was at, Ron was at his church doing this concert. I mean, yeah, doing this live concert. When I tell y'all it was packed, it was so packed. Let me tell you where this was because he still has the events up. RonKenoly has the events up on his website. Yes, he has a website. That's in the description of this video. Also, RonKenoly Ministries. You can go to RonKenoly.org and you'll find it. He was at this gentleman's church and the church name is Dunamis International Gospel Center and it's in Nigeria. Yes, child, Ron's all the way around the world, still traveling around the world. Nigeria. And was actually on March 29th of 2024. And you guys, he's going to be doing even more concerts. Let me show y'all the itinerary, but that's the pastor there, which that church was so packed. When I tell y'all they be doing it right in Nigeria, they be doing it right. So RonKenoly has his website and I invite you guys to go over there, check out his website. This is his website here. RonKenoly Ministries. You can go to RonKenoly.org. He is still doing great work for the kingdom. Great gospel music. Look at this. Still has gospel music out. Yes, he is still promoting, still doing great works out here. I mean, look at this. Look at Ron. Still doing great work. Now, here are his events over here. This is showing you the events, his itinerary that he has. At 79 years of age, RonKenoly is still out here doing concerts. Now, most of you might be some of my younger viewers. You may not remember, but ask if your mom was in church, ask your mom, ask your dad, ask your auntie and them, Ask them if they remember RonKenoly. They may tell you, yeah, they do. This is his itinerary. March 31st, he was still in Nigeria. He did a service over there. Let me move this over some. April 28th, for those of you who are in California, he's coming to California. April 28th at the Morris Cirillo World Evangelism Legacy International Center. He's going to be there in San Diego, April 28th. And then May 4th, he is going to be at Heart of the City Music Factory. Heart of the City Music Factory. Y'all can go to his website and check that out. Okay. Again, RonKenoly is doing concerts. And when I tell y'all, I am so happy about it. Now, there's a brief, just briefly again about Dr. RonKenoly. I put his Wikipedia page in there as well, so you guys can check that out also. It says here, according to Wikipedia, he expressed RonKenoly, songwriter, singer, leader, and worship leader whose expressed mission is to create an environment for the manifest presence of God. And he always loves to have large choirs. And when you look at that video that he did, the concert in Nigeria, you're going to see the magnitude. I thought the choir was part of like the audience. That's how big they were, huge. But he always loved large choirs. And just briefly, it says his success came in 1992 with Lift Him Up. That's when his success came. But he started out way before that. But 1992, Lift Him Up became the biggest selling worship album to that point. It also says that he dealt a little bit with R&B music. You know, songwriters and singers and stuff, they get started, you know, they try to, you know, different venues, different avenues that they think. They said in 1993, after two integrity recordings, he started receiving invitations from all over the world. Now, I wanted to do that because Lift Him Up was his breakout song, and that was in 1992. Within that year, I'm talking to all you gospel singers out there that are like, I want my gospel. I want to sing for the Lord. I want it to manifest. I want it to do great things. If you just stick with God, stay on course, and don't deviate, He'll make it happen like that. And you won't have to jump through hoops. You won't have to jump through holes. You won't have to go and do some of this stuff that people was doing. Diddy, them people. You won't have to do none of that stuff. God will direct your path. So in 1992, Lift Him Up became the fastest selling worship album. And then in 1993, year later, he started receiving invitations from all over the world. I know I'm helping somebody. Not just invitations down the street, the two churches at three doors down in the shopping center. Not just that, not to knock them, but I'm just saying. He was receiving invitations from around the world. Because why? Because he had then decided, I am going to do this for the Lord. Now, remember, I told you there was a brief part where he did some R&B. Okay. And it said also, churches not only wanted him to come lead praise and worship, but also to help them develop their music departments. Now, what? Y'all better trust in the Lord and all that he's doing. Trust him. All right. So it says here, for those of you who are out there and you're musicians, you're artists, you're singers, you want to do it for the Lord, and you might say, I'm having a hard time. I think I might just have to go over to the R&B sector. I think I might have to go over to secular music before I can really get my stuff going. And once I get big in secular music, then I'll come on back to the Lord. No, stay on course. Stay on course. Okay? And the reason why I put RonKenoly's Wikipedia page in there is because I want you who are out there, who are gospel singers, who are starting out, I want you to read about his story. It's brief. You don't have to act like you're reading the whole book. It's very brief, but it's very impactful, and it's very, very powerful. It's impactful too. Okay. It says that he started out doing some R&B. He started in the 70s, you know, he worked around R&B music in the 70s. And 75 and so forth. 83, in 1972, he did some music as well. But then it said in 1983, he decided to drop the R&B music and devote himself to a Christian life. Okay. He's born in 1944. He went into doing this music and trying to get his life together to try and join this music. It said in 1968, he joined the Air Force. And with him being in the Air Force, he started to get more passion for his music. So look at the timeline. 1968, he started to get a passion for music. The 70s, he decided he would just go into the R&B arena. 75, he's still in that R&B arena. And then 1983, he decided to drop the R&B and devote himself to a Christian life. Now get this, you guys. It said he tried for four years to get a gospel record deal. For 4 years. He tried for 4 years to get a gospel record deal. How many of y'all out there, musicians out there, artists, people who want to do things for the Lord, you don't even have to be a musician or artist, just ministry-wise. You want to do something for the Lord, and you say, Lord, it was easier when I was back doing stuff for the world. Now I'm trying to do stuff for the Lord. I'm trying to do stuff for you, and it's hard. Stay the course. Stay the course. Don't deviate. Because it says here, it took him 4 years to try and get a gospel record. 4 years to get a gospel record. In 1983, he released a custom-made album. You ought to listen to this. It was a project known around Kenoly's community, not internationally released. 4 years, you guys. Then it said Kenoly eventually started leading praise and worship for other pastors, such as Jack Hayford and Lester Summerall. Come on now, y'all know these names. This caught the attention of evangelist Mario Murillo, who introduced him to Pastor Dick Bernal, the founder of Jubilee Christian Center. RonKenoly became the church music leader minister in 1987. All right, so he tried 1983. Then 1987, he became the music ministry leader. Still stay in the course, you guys. Was it easy for him? It probably wasn't. I would love to interview Ron and get more in-depth information on this. But he did not give up. And then it says, after he was doing all of that, praise and worship leaders, going around still singing, trying to, you know, get the music out there. It wasn't until 1992, going back to the top of what I just told y'all, 1992, when he had his breakout release, Lift Him Up. 87 to 92. But that one song in 1992, Lift Him Up, listen to the title, Lift Him Up, Lift Him Up. That one song, Lift Him Up, was the song that catapulted his career from then to there. Y'all, on the next song that y'all do, listen to the title. What are you doing with that song? Who are you worshiping that song with? What are you doing with that song? Come on now. Y'all need to read Kenoly's background. Also, one tip I want to give y'all too before I give y'all all these links. RonKenoly, they said that Kenoly states that when his mother, Miss Edith Kenoly, was pregnant with him, she would rub her stomach and her prayer was, Lord, let this one praise you. Now, hold on. Now, I had to pause there for a moment because I was like, why is she saying let this one? What happened? Well, come to find out that Ron has, he has siblings. He has, I believe it's five other brothers. He has five other brothers. So his mother said for this one, she said, let this one praise you. And mothers, I want to say this to you. Those of you who are with child or you have children right now, I want to tell you something. What you speak over your children will become what you speak, unless the curse is broken. What you speak. This mother spoke over RonKenoly. She spoke that life into him, and that's exactly what he became. She spoke that life over him. You guys have to start speaking life over your children. Start letting them know who they are. So I love this RonKenoly story. It says here, RonKenoly has five brothers, including Mark Kenoly and Craig Kenoly, and three sons with his wife, Tavita. And he also had his two sons. There's two sons of his and his oldest son, Tony. They also had an album. He has two sons that have album. Let me show you that information. They call themselves the Kenoly Brothers, if I'm saying that wrong. Kenoly Brothers. Now, they have a short career. And I want to share with y'all something. They had a short career. I went online to try to find more information about them. And I did not find too much information, but I found this. This is a video that tells you what happened with these brothers. These are Ron's sons. They're two brothers, and they were doing music. They started out like Ron doing the gospel music. And then like Ron, they decided to go the way of R&B. But unlike Ron, they did not turn around, from my knowledge, and let me know in the chats, in the comments, if I have this incorrect, but they did not venture back to total praise and worship with God, I mean, to God, unless I haven't found it. But the similarity of this is interesting to me because Ron started out wanting to sing gospel, started singing gospel, but then got sidetracked and went and started singing R&B. But then found himself, like King Nebuchadnezzar said, wait a minute, let me get back to the Father, right? So then Ron decided to go back to gospel and full force with the gospel. His sons started out singing gospel. They went sidetracked, went to the R&B, allegedly, from what I'm finding, okay? Because there's very little on the sun, very little information online. And then they have dropped off. I don't see if they're doing anything. Now, I'm hoping during this time that they are still getting back to the life of knowing who Christ is and worshiping him and praising him. But there's very little love about them. But the same pattern, the similarity was just so interesting to me compared to what Ron has done. So I'm praying that these young men, as well as Ron's other son, will get back to knowing who Christ is. How can you have a parent that so much worships God that you get sidetracked? It's easy because a lot of ministers, children do that. But y'all check out, they do have some albums that are out. They have some stuff that's on Amazon. So y'all can check them out as well. Now, fun fact, I bet you guys would not remember, those of you who know Ron, you might know, but those of you who don't know, did y'all know that Ron Canole's cousin is Don Cheadle? Don Cheadle? Did y'all know that? I pulled up this stuff and I was like, what? I did not know that. Many of you probably did. Y'all know the famous actor. The famous actor here, Don. This is his cousin, according to the sources here on Wiki page. This is his cousin, Don Cheadle. Great actor. I love, love, love Don and his acting. He's an amazing actor. And, you know, I have not found any like mess on Don. I think he lives a respectful life. If there's anything out there, I just haven't seen it. But I love him as an actor. But this is his cousin. Hey, over there on Instagram, thank y'all for being here. That's his cousin. Now, Don was previously married. Ron was previously married to a lady by the name of, let me see, here's her information here. Let me bring up her information here so y'all can have that. Let me drop some of these links so I can get over here to these other links so y'all can see them. Okay, so he was married previously and his current wife's name is Tavita, but his previous wife, and when you look up, Wikipedia, it's not too much. His previous wife's name was Tavita. I think her name was Tavita. And he remarried. His new wife's name is Diana. Now, Diana, his new wife, Diana, they got married in November 24th of 2014. November 24th of 2014. Now, I could not find any information as to what happened as far as if there was a separation with Ron and Tavita, or I couldn't find out what happened with her. But I thought it interesting that he has remarried and they remarried in 2014. And his wife is gorgeous, y'all. gorgeous. Ron. Okay, Ron. Let me share y'all her. And let me tell y'all, she is not only gorgeous, but child, she is a UN ambassador. Yes. Check her out here, you guys. Look at how beautiful. This is from Ron's Facebook page. It says, I am truly blessed to have a wife of love, talent, wisdom, knowledge, beauty, class, patience with me, and understanding. It says, she has helped me through some major health crisis, personal misfortunes, and financial setbacks. Come on, ladies. Then it says, in the midst of many challenges and difficulties, she has become an executive director of the John Maxwell team, received a doctorate degree, became an ordained minister, and a United Nations ambassador. He said, in the midst of all of this, this lady was still doing all great things. Come on now. Great achievements, even through the midst of it. Ladies, catch some wisdom here. Catch some nuggets. Those of you who may be sitting there talking about, oh, my man got me going through all this, and I'm going through this, and he going through this and all this. Hey, Aaron. And you may be complaining, take some tips from her. Even through all the stuff she was going through, trying to help him get through, it did not stop her from pursuing her greatness. Examples. Come on now. This is a great example of a wife. It also says here in his Facebook page, I pray for a wife and our Heavenly Father gave me a Nubian queen. Oh. I know my Heavenly Father loves me, her excellently, and he's telling you about her excellently, excellency, ambassador, reverend, doctor, my wife, Diana Kenoly. Look at how beautiful she is, you guys. Beauty. Look at this. Come on, Nubian queen. Oh my goodness. Now, Ron, I'm not mad at you. I am not mad at you. Patience. Now, you guys, there is so much information that you guys can get out of this video if you really listen to the cues that I've given you. I'm not just sharing this video about Ron because I really love his music. I think he's a great singer. I think he's a great worship leader. I think he's a good praiser. I shared this video because I want you guys to be encouraged to know that those of you that are out there that are trying to sing for the Lord and you're like, nobody will give me a chance. I'm trying to get my voice out there to different churches. I'm trying to get people to hear me worship. I'm trying to get people to hear me sing and nobody wants to sing. Nobody wants to let me in their church to sing or on the pulpit to sing. Keep pressing, keep practicing, keep worshiping, because eventually God is going to put you in the presence of somebody that can get you in the presence of the multitude and the millions and on platforms all around the world. But you have to keep steadfast in what you are doing. Don't give up. Don't be moved. Be unshakable and keep pressing forward. Ron took him 4 years, 4 years, and he has a great voice and always had a great voice. So if you're out there and you get mad because the first church turned you down, the second, third, or fourth church turned you down, go back and read Ron's Wikipedia page and be encouraged and know, just keep on singing and worshiping. One day God is going to put you in the presence of many people. You have to be prepared, because one thing that Ron, I believe, kept doing was he kept on praising. Kept on singing, kept on worshiping. And he was steadfast in his journey. He had already did the R&B. He didn't want to do that anymore. He decided to put his path on the path that his mother had prayed for him to be. And he decided to lift up the Lord. He decided to say, I'm going to lift him up. And when you lift up the Lord is bound to lift you up too. So y'all be encouraged out here. Ron set the example. He also said in his Wikipedia page, oh, let me read this for y'all real quick before I get out of here, because this was encouraging. He said this. He said, as a child, I remember seeing Sammy Davis Jr. and Nat King Cole for the first time. I was so impressed as I watched two Black men grace a national stage. Two Black men grace a national stage. He said, I knew right then that what I want, that's what I wanted. So for the next few years, it didn't say for the next day or two. It didn't say for the next month. It said for the next few years. Some of y'all, it may take shorter than that because you got so many opportunities now that makes it easier. Back then, we didn't have the social medias like we do now. We didn't have all this other stuff. But be encouraged with this video that I'm sharing with y'all right now. Hey, Kim. Hey, Kim, thank you for being here, beautiful. Thank you. But be encouraged because it said for the next few years, Kenoly, Ron, poured all of his energy into making his childhood dream a reality. And he got sidetracked a little bit, but I believe he even used a little bit that where he went with the R&B as leverage. But imagine this, thank you, Holy Spirit. Imagine what would have happened if Ron had not detoured. Ooh, you know how when you going somewhere and you trying to get there and you finally do get there, but it took you longer because you were detoured. You got sidetracked. You made a wrong turn, went the wrong way, and you were delayed. Imagine if you were not detoured. Imagine if you would have stayed on the course. Imagine if you would have been patient in the process. Imagine if you wouldn't have been so hurried and ready and quick to try and get there and just move off track because you thought the way you were going was too slow. Imagine if you would have just stayed and wait. How much more God would have blessed Ron. Imagine, I'm looking at this now and I'm saying, man, God blessed Ron. I mean, he's almost 80 and looking like he's 60 and moving like a youngster. God's grace is sufficient. Come on now, take some lessons from Ron. Be patient. Wait on him. Come on now. Success. Success. He had success in the R&B arena, it said. He did. But when he finally woke up and said, it's time for me to lift him up. And when he did that, God said, now I can lift you up. Come on now, RonKenoly. I love it. Thank y'all. Thank y'all so very much for being here. Hello, beautiful. Hello. Thank you, Aaron. Thank you, Aaron, for being here. Hello again, Kim. Thank you for being here. Hey, Royalty Jukebox. She said, RonKenoly is my boy. God bless him, right? Woo-hoo. You guys, thank y'all for being here. Thank you, beautiful ladies, for being in the comment section. Thank you all who are going to watch this on the replay. RonKenoly, Kenoly, however y'all want to say his name. Y'all know who I'm talking about. Lift him up. He is still doing concerts. If y'all are in those areas that I mentioned, y'all need to go to that concert. Take your grandmas, your auntie them, your nana them, all of them, and tell them you're about to take them to a concert that they're going to enjoy. Y'all go and support Ron. I'm sure it's probably going to be a packed house, but I believe if you want to go, God will save a seat for you. Come on now. All right. I love y'all for being here today. Y'all stay blessed. I'm going to be right back with another video because remember that pastor that I talked to you about? You remember that pastor? Pastor Paul, where Ron just performed at his church? Well, he ain't playing in his church, y'all. He is not playing. He is not letting the devil come up there and run rampant. There's a video. Well, he showed the ministry and the members, all of that. He was like, listen, don't come in here with no lies in God's house. I'm coming right back with that video. Y'all ain't going to want to miss this. Click that notification bell. I'm about to go live with another one. Y'all go out there and support Ron. All the links are in the description of this video. Thank y'all for watching. Remember, if you have not subscribed to my channel here on my YouTube page, The Juice Radio and Talk Show, you want to do that, subscribe today so you don't miss out. Look for the red mug and microphone, and you know you will have the right channel. Here's a logo on the screen right here. Go over there to The Juice Radio and Talk Show. It's easy. We're a radio show and a talk show all in one here on The Juice Radio and Talk Show. Look for the red mug and microphone. Become a subscriber today and join all the happy folks that are already over here as great subscribers. All right. Love y'all for watching. I am going to see y'all on the next one. Now, y'all stay blessed and safe. And remember, love one another. But before you love anybody, make sure that you love, truly love yourself. Y'all be blessed. See ya.